Hi, I'm Elliot Fong. I'm here with Hong, the operations manager here at Young Master Brewery here in the south side of Hong Kong. Young Master's Brewery is one of Hong Kong's most exciting and prominent new breweries going on right now. And it was established in 2013 and just celebrated their third anniversary. So Hong, tell us a little bit about Young Master's.
So thanks, Elliot. So as you said, we just got 3 year old, and but actually, as you guys may see right now, this brewery is pretty impressive, at least for me. But actually, we started as we didn't start the brewery here. So the first brewery is actually located in other location, but still pretty close to the existing brewery now, around 5 to 10 minutes of a cab ride maybe. And that one is much smaller. The space is only about 1/3 the space, but the ceiling is much shorter because that was actually located on the fourth floor instead of the ground. And the system size is only 1/4 of the existing brewery. And we didn't do any bottling, well, except a few very special hand bottled beer there. So, but now we got a pretty nice, decent bottling line here. So we expanded here around 4 or 5 months ago. Actually, the first brew day of this brewery was in late July.
Oh, nice.
So
nice.
We're still pretty new, here.
Cool. Yeah. So what makes Young Master's distinctly Hong Kong? What makes it Hong Kong?
So Young Master Brewery, so we started as, we won't say we are the first brewery, because we are not, but when we started, well, or when the founder started this, the brewery was the only one in Hong Kong, because some other first brewery or brewery before established before closed down. So when we started it, it was only us, and we sort of, or it was kind of a good timing for us, because once we started after sometimes a few months ago, the whole scene, craft brewery scene in Hong Kong really started booming, and we, at least I myself, consider Young Master one of the pioneer in the Hong Kong craft brewery, craft beer scene. So how we picture ourselves, how we the philosophy or the whole vision of Young Master Brewery is, so we wanted to do some really high quality beer, or you can say we're trying to do some class beer. So we, but still, we have three different directions. So firstly, we want to do some traditional style, old style, classic style. Good. So we want to do, for example, as you can see, this beer, one of our bottle beers called Classic Pale Ale, is a pretty decent or pretty straightforward American Pale Ale. So for this one, we want to nail this. But on the other hand, we will also incorporate some existing style, and we'll put our own thought, put our own elements, or even a local elements to it. So for example, this beer, this is called Cha Chan Tang Goza. So as you guys may know, Goza, G-O-S-E, is quite a thing in American craft beer scene right now. So it's a sour beer and salty as well. So it's originated in Germany, but we put our own Hong Kong influence to it, because in Hong Kong there's some really local eating places called Cha Chan Tang. So in there you can get a really, really common drink, which you drink Sprite with the salt line. So okay. It got a little bit saltiness, slight acidity, but still really fizzy, refreshing. So we do this to the beer. So, but we, in terms of this creativity or experiment beer, we never go too far. Okay. Well, I'm saying this is because in the craft beer world now, many breweries trying to do beers very crazy, I'll say, because they will try to make some flavor combination which I think will not work. But we always, when we are trying to create a new beer, we always think, so maybe I want to do a local flavor, but still do this local flavor match with the original style. So this is also some thought we will always think about. So you can say we are a brewery, always want to push the boundary, but still we want to brew the beer that makes perfect sense in terms of flavor, profile, etc.
Cool. Yeah. Wait, so the salted lime, is this the salted lime right here?
This salted lime. So basically we house age this salted lime. How we do this is basically salt, lime, and thyme. So we soak this in the salt for, I think, at least 6 months.
Cool.
But I think this particular one is almost a year old now, as we did this, I think, in December.
Nice. Yep. So what about these other ones, these other ingredients, so traditional this, Chinese ingredients?
So these other traditional ingredients, sometimes for like an internal brainstorming, experimental purposes. So usually what you see, the liquids here are majority vodka, because when sometimes we want to play around experimenting new flavors, we will put some vodka in the ingredient and then try to soak it, the essence out of it, and then put it into the finished beer. So in this case, we can, the vodka is really good for extracting this flavor, but if we put it into a boil or etc. in the brewing process, this will kind of may extract some like unwanted bitterness of it. So we play around with this. Actually, this free one, we do not put this in our regular beers, but recently we did a custom brew for a local, like a Shanghainese restaurant, chain restaurant.
Cool.
So we celebrated their 15th anniversary in Hong Kong. So we put actually 15 Chinese ingredients to it, and these three are actually one of them. But having said though, I know you may already be like saying, oh wow, that's way too many ingredients for good beer. So actually we only focusing three of the main ingredients, which is the red date, Chinese red date, goji berry, and actually not this one, it's a flower of osmanthus. So mainly these three ingredients shine out the most, so it gives you really nice Chinese touch. Oh, by the way, the base beer was a wheat beer.
Oh, cool.
So, yeah, so we did this as well for our summer seasonal. We also added a local spice addition to the Belgian style wheat beer, because Belgian style wheat beer is meant to be brewed with different spices, and so that's what we do.
Cool, cool. So Young Master has done a lot of different collaborations.
Yeah.
One of them is with Boxing Cat in Shanghai. How did you get in touch with them? What's your relationship with them?
So I think Young Master, we didn't really get a lot of collaboration in terms of many different breweries. I think so far we've only done with two breweries. So one was in New Zealand Renaissance, and the other one was the Boxing Cat you mentioned. So actually, I don't really know how did we get involved in Boxing Cat, but very likely that the founder know the head brewer pretty well, so we started the conversation, and then we did a collaboration with Boston Camp, not a collaboration, but like a collaboration series.
Yeah.
So what we did with Boston Camp was brew a beer, what we call is a citrus IPA series, something like that. So the whole theme is to brew IPA with a citrus addition, I mean real fruit citrus addition. So I think the first one, well, this is a long time ago. I think there was one IPA we brewed with one is called a Buddha's Hand,
okay.
Something like a Bagamore type of citrus. We've done one with kaffir lime leaves, those like Thai cooking leaves within a IPA with some more lemony citrus hops addition.
Nice.
We recently did one in Shanghai with them for a orange tangerine, I think it's tangerine or mandarin, a real mandarin IPA. So I think upcoming we are still brainstorming it, but we may do a blood oranges type of thing.
Cool.
But
cool.
We are still thinking about what exactly to do and when to do. So usually what we do with them is one time we went to Shanghai, and then next time we came to Hong Kong, do a cruise here. And so it's like a running back and forth for the brewers.
Cool.
And well, I think in that case we will soon run out of citrus to figure out more beers.
So the founder is Rohit Dugar, who's I've never seen him before, but I saw a picture of him here.
Yep.
And I saw him at second draft a couple days ago, and yeah, I recognized him.
Yeah.
It's just pretty cool just to see.
You talked to him.
Good. I didn't because I didn't know who he was. I just saw him. And I was like, oh, that guy looks like a cool dude. Like,
yeah, you he's know. Very chill, calm guy. Yeah.
Cool.
He's very easy going.
Yeah, just like a random thought, you know, made those connections. But anyway, so I have to ask, what is your favorite Young Master ale?
So I got this question asked many, many times, but I still really can't pinpoint one single beer. But I think if you amend your question a little bit, like, because why I say this is because I like drinking Yamasa beer,
uh-huh.
But different beer is fits different occasion. Is it in the midday? Is it in winter? Is it in summer?
Okay. What about right now?
Right now.
What would you choose right now?
Right now. I mean, in this occasion.
Yeah, like right now.
Right now.
Like a meal?
No, I'm hungry now, so I don't want to drink such a heavy beer. Right now, I would maybe just go for the classic.
Classic?
It's always a great beer if you don't really have anything in your mind right now. Because
uh-huh.
It's always good for balance, hoppy, refreshing, easy drinking. Yeah.
Wait, and did I say that right? Miel?
Mio, yes.
Okay, cool. Cool. And that's with the barrel-aged ale.
Yeah, the barrel-aged quadruple. Yeah, Belgium quadruple.
Cool. So what beers do you usually like to drink? If it's like not Young Master, do you like Belgians? Do you like American IPAs?
I like sour beers.
Cool.
I like heavy beers too. I like malty beers. I like hoppy beers too, but I think I like malty a bit more. But let me put it this way. So when I first really got in touch with craft beer, mm-hmm. So exploring two different styles, I really like to drink some heavier stuff because we all know craft beer is not cheap, right? So you go for each, how should I say, once you pay for the same or similar amount and to get like a heavier, stronger.
Get more alcohol?
No, not more alcohol, but more flavor,
okay.
Stronger flavor. But later and later, when I explore to more different more style, I start to really appreciate more about those more sessionable style, maybe like a pale German Helles, maybe like a traditional English bitter. This is all I like, but I think if you really want me to pick a style I really like, or top two or three styles, I would say a Flanders Red, I would say a Scotch Wee Heavy, and what else? I can't think of else right now. Maybe a lambic. Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
I like lambics. Sweet. Oh, you've done. Young Master has also done collabs with other local Hong Kong companies like 18 Grams Coffee.
Yes.
You did the stout, coffee stout. What other projects are you guys thinking about doing?
So currently, in terms of local collaboration, apart from collaboration with breweries, so actually we've done quite a few times. So first, as you mentioned, 18 Grams, that is a coffee oatmeal style,
mm-hmm.
Originally brewed early this year, but it was very popular, and then we brewed this again in a bigger batch, a little bit heavier too, and we will release the bottle very soon. So 18 Grams is one of the example, collaboration-wise. I'm not sure if that's really a collaboration, but we brew an exclusive beer for a local, the Mandarin Oriental Hotel in Hong Kong.
Oh,
the bar is called Captain's Bar. It's like a German pale lager-ish, but not like a pilsner, maybe close to a Helles. And we only brew it for them. We can only drink it there, not even here, sorry. So this, we brewed a custom brew beer for local craft beer bars called Roundhouse.
Oh, okay.
That, quite a few times, actually. The first time was a smoky, like a light-colored smoke beer. The second is it's a little bit smoke, but it's with a grape think it's grapefruit addition, like a grapefruit smoked amber ale. And then we recently did another grapefruit again, but not smoked this time, a grapefruit Berliner Weiss for them. And then, of course, for example, this ingredient, we did it with the local Chinese, not local, I think they're from Singapore, Chinese restaurant, that's Crystal J. It's like a lot of Chinese ingredients, so this sort of collaboration, we do as well.
Cool. So, what's at the, is there a special Young Master beer at the Roundhouse right now?
Yes, like right now? Well, they are not saying it's Young Master beer, they'll say it's like a Young Roundhouse house brew.
Okay, cool.
But
cool.
They are okay to tell that we are brewing it, and okay. It's like an open secret.
Nice,
yeah,
cool.
Everyone knows it.
Cool, so looking forward, what other projects, what other things is Young Master, you know, looking toward?
Looking to in terms of projects, there are a few is under negotiation right now, but since I think all of them are now confirmed, I cannot tell many things about it. But at least in terms of direction, we are looking forward to if you see this in camera, this is a fooder, by the way. This is a traditional Belgian oak fermenter, mainly using for sour beer, and this is actually the first one in Asia. So we just brew a beer for this one, uh-huh. So we are looking forward to aging it longer, a few months, half a year, with some wild yeast bacteria addition to it. This one we're really excited about. And others, for example, we are also looking into possibilities in distributing in other countries, region. I think we are currently looking into Singapore right now. But before that, you can only buy Young Master beer in Hong Kong. Well, there are a few events that we send beer outside, for example, Michaela Bar in Korea, Taiwan Beer Festival in Taipei. Before there was another craft beer festival in Beijing as well. By the way, we also have bottles sold in Macau too. Oh, but that technically is one country, so. We're looking forward to exploring.
Nice. Yeah. Cool. So, anything else you want to add? Maybe something I might have missed?
It's not really a lot of things I want to add. You, because it's pretty good already in terms of the whole Young Master brewing philosophy, vision, etc. But, if you guys are in the States, we hope that sometime we will do some, I don't know, events, collaborations with the breweries in the States side, or even exporting. Or you got any chance, you got friends, relatives coming to Hong Kong, ask them to look for us, bring your bottle, or a crowler, we do crowler now as well. So I think so as is, stay tuned, we'll try make our own unique and very tasty beer.
Okay, cool. Hong, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Nice
meeting you.
Nice to meet you.